The world is changing, and so are today's power engineers and their professional society. There is little doubt that today's world is beyond the wildest dreams of our ancestors. Europe, with its 500 million customers, has a total installed electric capacity of 650 gigawatts, consuming 3,000 terawatt hours per year. Today, the renewable energy consumption is at around 10% of the total. By 2020, the European Union has set the very ambitious target of having 20% of renewables. In Europe, engineers have provided industry and consumers with safe and reliable electric power using coal, nuclear, gas, and oil as fuels. But that all changed. Today, engineers are seeking new solutions to provide clean and reliable energy.
We think that the potential for wind energy is a very huge potential.
An important factor accelerating wind development was the involvement of the government.
Germany is applying a feed-in tariff, which means that for a given amount of electricity fed into the network, you get a fixed price. This was implemented in 1991, so we have almost 20 years of experience, and this experience has shown that the feed-in tariff, even though economists do not like it, works in practice.
European countries have been aggressive in balancing environmental concerns with market realities. Yet countries in Europe and elsewhere continue to depend on nuclear and thermal power plants to provide base load.
We used to say in France, no oil, no gas, no coal, no choice. So in the 70s, the nuclear was, I would say, the only solution for the country. So we decided to turn completely to nuclear, so that now we have 80% of electricity which is produced by nuclear, with 58 reactors on 19 different sites. So we know that we are one of the most nuclear countries in the world.
The transmission of energy within and among countries in Europe continues to be a challenge.
You are here in the National French Control Center. We had some problems with some perhaps interconnectors with our neighbors, and we have to manage the international exchanges taking into account this problem with the interconnection lines.
With the goal of developing energy sources to meet current and future needs, engineers are working on solutions to reduce carbon emissions through coal gasification and sequestration.
The pilot plant that is here below us is the first visual site of a large research and development project, which has the aim to produce a result in a commercial concept for how you could actually build fossil fuel power plants without any CO2 emissions. We're looking into storing it about 1 kilometer deep underground.
Well, I think carbon sequestration is relatively easy in depleted oil and gas fields, and it's already practiced at a significant scale. It's more difficult once you want to put it at the deep water level, which is also a much more sensitive political issue.
Europe is now center stage for technology as well as public policy innovation. Places like Freiburg, Germany, are testing the boundaries for renewable energy and energy conservation.
We have more bicycle lanes, 460 kilometers of bike lanes. We have the Fraunhofer Institute of Solar Energy, where 600 students, professors, researchers work on the renewable energies.
Europeans are developing all kinds of energy sources.
We are doing work here on cooling, and especially on cooling with renewables, or to be more precise, we want to produce cold from waste heat, produce cold from solar heat, produce cold from district heat. So not produce cold from electricity, but from other energy sources.
And it's a basic research institute. The point is related to solar energy research. And there the main focus is on thin film photovoltaics, dealing with different materials, mainly compound semiconductors, so CIGS-based systems, or on the other one it would be silicon-based thin film photovoltaics.
European countries are looking into solar energy for large-scale energy development.
We are in the solar thermal plant of Puerto Llano. This plant that is under construction is our first plant. Local authorities has been very interested. They have helped us to get all the permits required to begin the construction of a plant like this.
Universities and research labs in Europe are in the forefront of finding solutions.
We have organized ourselves in five thrust areas. The first one is generation efficiency, which is, for example, looking at efficient photovoltaics or efficient gas turbines. We have then the transmission and distribution efficiency, where we look at smart grids and demand-side responses. We have the demand-side efficiency. We have then furthermore the enabling methods, which are more focused on the mathematics side. And finally, the economic and social sciences for energy.
Engineering education and research have played a crucial role in accelerating the development of renewable energy in Europe. In Madrid, the Comillas Pontifical University is preparing students for the power and energy sector.
We are working on the design of the engineering courses, both in the subjects and in the design of the whole syllabus, trying to integrate the concept of sustainability, both in the technical, social, and economical aspects.
The Power and Energy Society plays an important facilitating role.
I'm still a member, in fact, for a year now. And well, more than IEEE conferences like PowerTech or last week have been to Israel, to a convention of IEEE. 2 years ago, I went to the PowerTech in Lausanne.
Although IEEE is seen as a place for publishing papers in journals and conferences, we, from the Spanish chapter of the PES Society, we try to emphasize the connection between IEEE and engineers in the industry through seminars of hot topics of the power industry.
But promoting the IEEE continues to be a challenge.
And I think it's a good if faculty take a lead, especially those who have a foreign experience. And they already know the IEEE from our literature research extensively from the IEEE Explore. And the next step would be to provide networking opportunities and especially bringing also the students and the employer side together.
The IEEE Power and Energy Society has made significant contributions through its publications and conferences. The PowerTech Conference, organized by the IEEE, is held every odd year in Europe. IEEE will continue to support the work of today's power and energy professionals in Europe to meet the challenges of tomorrow. We will advance alternative forms of energy, wind, solar, biomass, geothermal, tidal and wave energy from the oceans. We will refine existing technologies like nuclear energy and strive for cleaner coal power through gasification and sequestration. We will find new ways to reduce energy consumption. We are on the forefront, pushing the envelope and spreading best practices. And supporting our work is PES, continuing to provide benefits to engineering professionals and their employers through conferences, technical committees, publications, network opportunities, and standards development. PES, powering the future.